Oops. What parts do you need for a weed whacker? Well, basically a motor, blade, and a handle to hold that thing. Motor is easy. Just take whatever you have that is powerful enough. I just have this here lying around, a brushed motor. Handle is also relatively easy because broomsticks have standardized threads. So actually you can simply print a 3D part that screws in here like so, and on the other side holds the motor. It's easy enough. Blade can be a bit more complicated, but you can make things simple by simply using zip ties. So I 3D printed this part here, which has some holders for the zip ties. Of course, you can put the motor on here. And there are also some fan blades that pull in the air through these holes and blow the air through the motor to keep it cool. And yeah, basically, if you combine these things, you have a very simple weed whacker. A thing of beauty. Not really, but it is functional. So here we have the battery and an ugly mounted switch. And as you can tell, does its job. When doing these sorts of things, always protect your eyes. Right, let's see how that goes. Well, that's a bit underwhelming. This was just one cell, so four walls. Let's go to two cells and boost that up to 8 volts. Ooh, that sounds scary. Perfectly. So let's have a look at the zip ties. Still look good as new. And the motor temperature? Very cool. Let's now punish them a bit and hit that rock. Pretty much unimpressed. Well, the edge is off a little bit, but not really much. Well, great. All in all, I'm actually quite happy how this turned out. So it's quite a useful tool, and I was even surprised how well these zip ties seem to last. So initially I thought, well, they are easily replaceable, no worries, but actually they're lasting longer than I was expecting them to do, so that's great. Well, I think I will keep this in my garden toolbox. All right, thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye.